What is the problem then with homosexual practice? Let's think a little bit philosophically about it. This is what's hard for people to explain, because as with incest, it's one of those irreducible minimums of sexual ethics. So people really find it hard to explain what's really wrong with it. There's several dimensions that are wrong with it. Number one, sexual self-deception. It's a conceiving of the sexual same as though the sexual same were a sexual other in relation to oneself, a sexual complement to oneself. That's self-deception. Because a person of the same sex is not your sexual counterpart, by definition. The sexual counterpart to a male cannot be another male. The sexual counterpart to a female cannot be another female. And to think that that is the case, which implicitly, tacitly one does when you enter into a sexual union with another, since we ourselves individually are not complete sexual beings, is self-deception. This is also what Paul would call sexual dishonor. He uses the explicit term of dishonoring themselves because it treats their maleness, if male, or femaleness, if female, as only half intact in relation to their own sex, right? The logic of a heterosexual union, two halves of the sexual spectrum unite to form a single sexual whole. What's then the parallel logic in a homosexual union? Two half males become a whole male, two half females become a whole female. That's a dishonoring of the stamp of gender on their body.